This is one of our 6x10 jaw crushers, and I wanted to do a short maintenance and operation video for these. And this will be the same for our 6x10, 8x12, and 10x16 jaw crushers. So the first thing is going to be how to change the jaw plates. This is looking down the jaws here. The first step is to take out these two bolts, one and two, which go all the way through the movable jaw. You can see them, they come out in the back here. So just take off those two nylocks, tap the bolts out, and these two wedges will come out, and that movable jaw will be able to be lifted out by hand. Once the movable jaw is out, the two cheek plates need to come out, and that's done by removing this bolt up under there. Easier to see on this side, one on each side. Once these bolts are out, the cheek plates will come out, and you just stick a pry bar in there and you can wedge them out with those D holes there. And once the cheek plates are out, the stationary jaw will be able to be lifted out by hand. The jaw plates are flippable and they wear more heavy down in the bottom half than on the top half. So once they wear out in the bottom half, you can flip them over. And once you remove the jaw plates, turn them over to replace them. Put the stationary jaw back in first. Slide down the cheek plates and drive them down with the big hammer or a maul on the top on both of those before tightening up the bolt. Once these are driven down tight, tighten up the bolt on each side and then put the movable jaw back in, install the two wedges, put the bolts through, and tighten up the nylock on the back. As you tighten up the nylock on the back, it's best to tap these wedges and bolt heads with a hammer, and it will help the bolts get tight. So you tap them, tighten them up on the back, come back and whack them a couple more times, tighten them up. It's best to do it with two people so one guy can bang the wedges as the other guy's tightening them. There are four grease fittings on this machine, two here and two here. And for proper greasing, there should just be a little tiny bead of grease coming out between the bearing housing and the shaft. And we put some grease in the bearings, but as you run them, the first half an hour or so, check and make sure that there's a bead of grease there. If there's not, add five more pumps of grease and run it for another half an hour so everything gets nice and warm in here. The grease can come out and make that seal. Grease doesn't need to be flying off the shaft, just a small bead of grease around the bearing housing and the shaft to keep dust and particulates out of the bearings. To adjust the jaw gap, there's two adjustments to be made. This is the vertical threaded rod, and this is the spring tensioner rod. To tighten the jaw plates, you take the vertical threaded rod and tighten the bolt so the rod will come up. That pulls a wedge, pulls this wedge up, which pushes this toggle shuttle forward, pushes the toggle plate forward, and closes the jaw gap. Now, as you're doing that, you may need to tap this with a hammer lightly to get it loosened up as you tighten the jaw plates. As you tighten, or before you tighten the jaw plates, you can loosen this tensioner spring, and that runs all the way through and grabs the back of the jaw plate so the jaw plate isn't flopping around under operation. So this needs to be snug but not too tight, so when the jaw plates close it collapses all the way and damages the spring or the rod, and not too loose that it's clanking around. And to open the jaw plates, it's the reverse. You drop this rod down, this whole mechanism slides back, opening the jaws, and then you'll need to tighten this up to keep tension, the proper tension on the spring. After any adjustment is made to the jaws, either replacing them or tightening or loosening them, it's important to take off one of the guards and rotate the jaw over by hand a few times to make sure that these teeth mesh and don't hit or bind. Because if the jaw crusher is started and the teeth don't mesh, you may damage the crusher or the jaw plates. Other things that need to be checked on this machine are the belts, especially after the first couple hours of operation. The belt tension may need to be changed, because as you're running, the belts will stretch initially just a small amount. To tighten the belts, you can loosen the motor bolts, and using these adjustment screws, you can pull the motor back, which increases tension on the belt. Another thing to check after your first couple hours of operation is go through and check the bolts and nuts for tightness, especially these two on the jaw plate and these two on the cheek plates. And it may take a little while for those bolts to get nice and tight when it's operating, because there's a lot of force going on there and these things need to be nice and tight. The rotation of the jaw crusher wheels is clearly marked on the side of the guards. If you just bought a jaw crusher with no frame or motor, you probably didn't get guards with it. If you're standing at the jaw crusher, the flywheels will be rolling towards you, and the jaw will be going up and down, force feeding the material down into the jaw crusher. If it's running backwards, the jaw will be pushing the material back up and out, and the jaw crusher won't be nearly as effective. We have electric, gas, and diesel options for these smaller jaw crushers. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give us a call or email us anytime, all of which is available in the description below. So thanks for watching, and enjoy your machine.